local event winners Reba McEntire and Linda Davis are at opposite ends of the spectrum. Reba's won a lot of these, but it's Linda's first.
You got a place to keep that?
You bet. Right now I'm trying to figure out where that's going to be. We don't have a mantle in our house, so maybe the centerpiece of the table?
Album of the year seemed to go to everyone.
Last year at the CMAs, all eyes were on Reba as she revealed a dress that was seen around the world. This year, millions of viewers were sitting on pins and needles to see if fashion history would repeat itself. So before the awards, we sent Jan Snyder straight to the designer to find out.
R-E-S-P-C-T. Had country's good girl gone bad? Should this cleavage receive a commendation or a cloak? Would Reba be as daring this year? Only her designer would know for sure.
It was red velvet trimming and it fit me good. Standing back from the looking glass, there stood a woman where a half-grown kid had stood. She said, here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. She said, here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down.
She has no limits. She's, the sky's the limit.
Sandy Spica has been designing Reba's clothes for over 8 years.
She wore this 2 years ago for the CMA Award Show when President Bush was here.
Last year's CMA creation is now known as the Red Dress.
I wondered if maybe I'd get fired for it, but that didn't happen. I thought she looked great.
Following the Red Dress would be a very difficult task for someone. I mean, like you said, it made headlines. What'd you think about when you designed this year's dress?
Reba came to me and said, I would love a dress for the CMAs that was a purple blueberry color and yellow, bright yellow. These are three end products of sketching for her CMA dress. I'll pull out my favorites and present those to her.
She said, here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. Here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down.
2 days before the awards, Sandy's assistants were stitching away. There are nearly as many beads on this dress as Reba's record sales. In another room, Sandy is putting the finishing touches on Faith Hill's dress.
This is going to be her first CMA performance, so I'm really excited for her.
Like Faith, Linda Davis asks Sandy to design her CMA dress in basic black.
And it's very fitted and very short.
If all goes as planned, Sandy has about 2 months prior to an award show to design and deliver a dress. It takes her a bit more time for Reba's stage show.
I always have to keep in mind for quick changes, tearaways, things that come off easily or are put on easily, that is a big consideration to start out with. She changes clothes about 13 times in a show.
Wow.
Stealing the show has always been Reba's intention. So Wednesday night, when Sandy's creation draped so beautifully on Reba, would the world forget about the red dress?
And just think about this time last year, I'd have had about half of a dress on.
Half a dress. It was the right half she had on.
Perhaps some things aren't meant to be forgotten.
Sandy also designs for other stars like Ricky Van Shelton and Ronnie Dunn. This year, CMAs weren't without controversy.
Reba McEntire returns for the ninth time as a nominee in this category. She was booked for 130 road dates this year, virtually all of them sold out, and has sold more than 22 million albums in her career.
It's hard. Oh, it's hard. It's like trying to get blood out of a turnip. It's like trying to pull your wisdom teeth. You know, I don't see how they do it. Go in there and set and write a monster song without the song.
You and I know that life's a game.
And Reba McEntire is certainly no stranger to the field. She's been nominated every year since 1983 and won it 4 consecutive years, but she still gets excited.
It would mean that I would be just screaming. I would be thrilled to pieces. I won my first award in 1984, 10 years ago. So to make it a 10-year winning streak, it would be the icing on the cake.
The
We have not only the management and the talent and our publishing and our advertising.
Yeah, he saw me at that blame door.
Reba McEntire is the cover girl on this month's Ladies Home Journal. In the article, she said, "I'm very competitive. Like, the more times I don't win Entertainer of the Year, the more I want it. I'm greedy." Reba has so many projects lined up for this year that she says everyone will OD on her. One plan in the works is a made-for-TV movie based on her video, Is There Life Out There? McEntire is credited with doing a lot of things, including building Linda Davis's career with their duet, Does He Love You? Well, now Reba is doing another kind of building, the kind that involves hammer and nails.
¼ inch.
I'll be the cheerleader. How about that?
Reba McEntire lends her support to a unique construction project. It's a home built entirely by women.
I enjoy helping people in general, but when it's your, as the lady said today, your sisters, that's really special. That's a lot of fun, and I'm blown away with what the gals have done here today.
This project is sponsored by Habitat for Humanity. Their goal is to build affordable housing for people in need.
When we approached the people at the Habitat for Humanity, then they decided it'd be a great thing, since I'm a woman and donating the money. Why don't we have a woman builder, woman contractor, a woman plumbing supply, everything. And the women are out here building the house today.
Sub-fascia, got it.
It started out as an idea, I wonder if we could do it, and then the energy was obviously there, and it was one of those things that just, it fell into place.
There you go.
Head builder Sharon Lester is not only a professional, she's a volunteer as well. In fact, all of her workers, about 400 in all, are donating their time and skills, or lack thereof.
Well, initially it was a little bit disorganized, but it didn't take quick for them to fall right in line, because everybody was watching and looking and wanted to be involved and wanted to do it right, and we started showing them how to do it, and I turned it over to them in about an hour, and that's what they've been doing ever since.
Reba admits her home building experience is limited, but she embraced this cause after seeing former President Jimmy Carter's involvement with the organization.
And I'd seen for years, you know, him out there hammering with his hat on. I thought that was really neat to help folks out that needed a helping hand.
Thanks for joining us.
I mean, even I almost could dance. It was so good.
Great. It's just as I expected it would be. It's just wonderful. As a matter of fact, it surprised even us, and we may have to collaborate more often in the future.
When we were still on stage, she said, I said, Natalie, you're great. She said, let's do this again. I mean, she's already booking us.
The show ended with a grand finale jam, but the spirit of the evening was best summed up by Aaron Neville.
Sing music.
Well, what a difference a week makes. True to their word, Reba and a group of women built a Nashville Habitat home in just 9 days.
And I also have a set of keys. A set of keys that are going to unlock the doors of a house built with love, built with teamwork, built by women.
Stormy skies and muddy grounds didn't rain on Reba's parade. Yesterday, she joined the women who built this home called A Woman's Place. Last week, a group of volunteers began constructing the house. Their goal was to complete it in 9 days, an ambitious effort, but one that Reba had full faith in.
You put a woman on a project, it's gonna get done.
In an emotional ceremony, Reba handed the keys to the recipient of the house, Gail Kinzer.
I've really been blessed. Lord has really blessed me and my family.
The blessings didn't stop there. Before the event was through, Reba made a special announcement.
Narvel and I would like to fund another house next year.
That's great.
Celebration underway. Because it's her birthday.
It's her birthday. Lady. And she went to a surprise party for her birthday.
Right. And we have her ready. Ladies and gentlemen, Reba McEntire. We welcome you to Music City tonight. There's Reba.
Reba.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Reba.
First of all, Reba, happy birthday. And were you surprised at your party when you arrived?
Surprised. I kept telling Narvel when we drove up here that I said, Narvel, there's too many people here to go skating. And he said, oh, no, it'll be fine. And then I walk in, and it's all the people from Starstruck and all my friends, and I was so surprised.
Is today your birthday, Reeb? Today?
Today's my birthday, y'all.
Is it
and,
really?
And we're celebrating the same anniversary. I'm 30.
Oh,
all
right.
well,
here's
well,
for
plus
you,
a
Reba.
Little.
Roll us a chord. Okay.
Happy birthday to you.
Thanks.
Happy birthday.
Remember the first time that you actually worked with these guys, we were, I guess it was around in Maggie Valley, was it? You were doing a special?
Yes, we were.
And Reba, you were there, and I'm curious about your first impressions of working with four crazy guys like the Statler Brothers.
I was in heaven working with the Statler Brothers because I had been doing nothing but clubs, and the smoke is getting to me so bad that I knew that if I didn't get out of the clubs pretty soon, I wasn't going to have a throat. And the Statler Brothers came to my rescue and put me on the road with them, put me on their special, and we had a blast, and I hope they adopted me real quick because I wanted to stay with them a long, long time.
Well, yours? Reba, we want to tell you, happy. Well, you don't look 60, I want to say that. No, the trick is to tell everybody you're 60. And then the first thing they'll say is, gee, you really look good for that.
Yeah.
So you always jump up a few.
Well, y'all,
you're a sweetheart. We love you.
That's right.
I love y'all more. Congratulations on your 30th anniversary. I sure am proud for y'all.
Thank
Let's
you.
Let's hear another 30,
Thank you,
okay?
Sweetheart. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank y'all. Right. Love you.
Thank you,
Reba. That's nice of her to do that on her birthday.
Birthday, she's taken time out from skating to talk with you guys. And when you first heard her voice and saw her perform, did you know that she was a star?
Yeah. Told a story before. This is a true story. Jerry Kennedy, who is our producer, and he was at Mercury Records at the time, and I called him one day. I had never heard of Reba McEntire. She was brand new, and I talked to Jerry one day on the phone. I said, what's going on? He said, I tell you, I've got a real problem. And here's a guy that's got one of the best musical ears I've ever heard. He said, I've got a real problem. He said, I've got a pretty redheaded girl from Oklahoma that sings so good, I can't tell whether the song's any good or not.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. That's a true story.
That's quite a compliment. Now, you know,
sure
times
is.
Change over the years, and granted, over the years, you gentlemen have always afforded new artists a chance to open for you, to tour with you, and to really get their career going. Does that continue today?
By the end of the year, Reba McEntire belted and strutted her way onto the list of the top five touring acts of any musical genre. But she began March with a different honor.
Reba McEntire.
The month of March saw Reba McEntire winning Favorite Female Country Performer at the annual People's Choice Awards.
Thank you very much for keeping the groceries on the table.
Alabama!
I'm very blessed with the things I have.
Her fans enjoyed a chance to see Reba McEntire in a different light in October, playing opposite Burt Reynolds in a TV movie, The Man from Left Field. However, her three-year-old found it confusing.
He said, you go out with Dad, you don't go out with Burt Reynolds. I said, come on, let's go talk to Mr. Reynolds. So I went over there and Burt explained, you know, it's just pretend, this is movies and you'll see it on TV.
He said,
does have as an angel on earth. Jan Snyder tells us about Reba's generous donation.
The minute she walked in the room, you could tell she was a woman of distinction, a real big lender.
But I will be there to help out any way I can.
Reba McEntire is lending her time, energy, and passion, and giving her money to Habitat for Humanity to build a house for this woman.
Gail Kinzer.
This project, dubbed A Woman's House, will be built within a span of 9 days by women in the Nashville community. Gail will be charged only for the cost of the house, and her mortgage payments will go to build more homes for deserving families. Reba endorsed the selection of Gail for the project.
And she was in a part of the town where she wasn't comfortable, and she was scared a lot of times, and her kids couldn't go out to play. And I think that alone, children not being able to go outside and play safely, is a mother's greatest fear. And so I think they chose Gail, mainly for her kids, to have a safe place to go outside and play.
This press conference luncheon enabled Reba to show off her prowess with a toolbox, being challenged by a member of the audience to name each tool.
Okay, this is a Phillips, thank you so much. See my partner here? My partner. I told you this was going to take teamwork.
Reba keeps trying.
Crescent wrench? Yeah. What do you think?
It's like a top.
Egg separator.
To Gail, Reba has used the most important tool.
Anything about football?
Close. Nut driver. Well, I had the screwdriver part right. Okay.
Coming up, it's tool time for country superstar Reba McEntire. Stage, duet partners Linda Davis and Reba McEntire are working out the kinks for their performance.
And I just know one of these nights, one of us are going to crack up and start laughing.
Hopefully it won't be tonight.
Oh, good thinking.
Cock one of those eyebrows and I'm out of here.
Oh, really? Is that what does it?
That'll do it.
And tonight there are dueling duets.
It's going to be neat. I didn't know she was doing the duet with Linda, so... Reba will be the duet queen of this special, I guess.
And he told me I was giving him the same looks that I gave Linda, so he said to get that straightened out.
Now, don't take that tone with me in this duet that you do with Linda, where you yell at me. So I'm not going to blow up on a boat. Don't blow me up, okay?
But Reba got the last laugh.
Come here.
No.
Come here.
I'm really... Oh, nice dress, Linda.
You're still the other woman. I can't believe it. Hey,
what?
You remember last year when we did this duet together?
Vaguely.
I appreciate you getting all those extra sales for me. Well, it went double platinum, and I wanted to give this to you.
Great. You can see Hot Country Jam 94 February.
Movie, and there's a film crew covering her shoot down in the state of Florida.
Yeah, this
today.
Is her third movie.
When I was a kid, I'd play like... me being in the movies and being the Scarlett O'Hara or the person that always got the guy. Yeah, I always wanted to be in the movies when I was a kid. Kenny Rogers and Burt Reynolds, I don't think I could have picked two men to get to work with that were any nicer, more fun. They tell old war stories and just keep everything in a real light mood on a movie set, which is very important to me. Burt's helped me in my acting. Like, if I do a scene, he'll kind of... I didn't really think he was coaching me at first. We were just having a conversation. And then, ding, I realized he's trying to get a point across to you, nitwit. Pay attention. And, of course, I was hanging on every word he said. The film clips that we do at our shows gives a different... I think it lets the audience see there's another side of Reba McEntire while she's on stage. Not only does she sing, but then they look up at the screens and they say, oh, she's an actress too. Or she's acting anyway, or trying to. And I think it's a great way to show the different sides of Reba McEntire.
God has a tendency to be rough on poor people.
No, he doesn't.
You just said he did.
I don't know what you mean.
You just said you were one of the have-nots.
Well, I didn't mean... Okay. I'm very blessed with everything I have, and I appreciate you very much for pointing that out to me. Basically, what I really am looking forward to do is more movies that children can go see with their parents in the theater. And when they lease the video later on, it's something that the whole family can sit down and watch. I'm really looking forward to do movies like that.